So Growmatik is a cross-channel marketing automation platform that unifies everything you need to build smart marketing campaigns, which means smart web pages, smart emails, and smart pop-ups. And the smart capacity that I'm talking about is made possible by two important factors: advanced targeting accuracy and highly relevant content. So automation dashboard in Growmatik includes two main sections. Event trigger are the things that happen in real time. For example, when the target of this automation, coming from a specific website or visiting from a specific geolocation, as I'm scrolling, you can see them, or if they open an email or click on an email, as well as shopping events, for example, when they place an order or completing an order, or when they abandon a cart. And then we have audience. So audiences is a group of people who have something in common with regards to their past behavior in and outside your website. So in this case, I'm not gonna use any of these filters and directly use one of my saved segments. Saved segments are those that I have created in the past, or ready-made segments by Growmatik that I will cover later on. So this is how I chose my audience. I'm going to choose an action. So as you can see, the actions are two types. There are on-site actions and off-site actions. On-site actions cover pop-up, showing a pop-up, page redirections, or personalizing a page. And off-site actions are sending an email, adding and removing tags, unsubscribing the audience, and more. So in this example, I'm going to choose showing a pop-up. You see, when you choose the action, the details about that action is defined within this panel. So I'm going to start by defining the design of my pop-up. There's a range of different ready-made templates for pop-ups and emails the same way that you can choose from. And in this case, I'm going to use this template. And when I click on it, the pop-up builder comes up. You have all the options to visually actually customize the content here. You can also add different new elements such as image, text, icons, buttons, and dynamic content like coupons and product list. As you can see, a dynamic coupon is completely functional, and you can simply come and define, you know, the products that you want to apply to the coupon, as well as the type of discount. You just, for example, make the amount of this percentage discount that you want, change the font, you know, the same way, the appearance, alignment, again, the color, as well as all the other visual details. Let's make it red in this case. And by the way, you can actually preview your pop-up in mobile viewport as well. So I just saved my design for my pop-up, and here are some more options I can choose from. For example, I'm going to set on-page exit as the exact time that I want the pop-up to display, and going to save my rules. So my automation rule is now saved and ready to execute. So all of the leads in my website who have registered in my website are going to see this pop-up when they are trying to exit the page, and they will be able to use a functional dynamically created coupon. I'm going to create an automation that uses a event trigger. In this case, I'm going to choose the traffic source, and I want a specific domain of appsumo.com to be the subject of my automation. And I'm going to touch the audience, and I'm going to choose page personalization. So this means everyone coming from appsumo.com will be seeing a personalized version of my landing page, for example. So I'm going to create a personalization which is 100% visual and quote-free personalization environment. So for example, I want to change this, you know, heading to, and also I want to, let's say, add a piece of dynamic product list here, which means the only the people coming from appsumo.com will see this specific product list that I can customize based on these criteria. In this case, I'm going to choose discounted products. I can play by these numbers, see I can change the number of columns and total quantity, as well as playing with the hiding image, description, price, changing the size of the elements like typography, changing their color, as you can see, and the same way for other elements as well. So this means everyone coming from appsumo.com will be seeing a personalized version of my landing page. To create a automation that includes both trigger action, in this case, let's say order placed, as well as a specific behavioral record, for example, total spent, which we can find here in total spent. And I'm going to define, you see all of these items, you can define the amount, let's say 1000, and you can define in what period of time this has been the case. I'm going to save the audience. So right now my target is everyone who places an order, and also they have purchased a total of $1,000 in the past, and I want them to receive an email from me. This goes best with, I'm gonna choose a dynamic keyword of last purchased items. So it means the name of the items that they have just purchased will appear in the email. And I'm gonna choose this as a transactional email, and I'm gonna use this template. So as you can see, this is a ready-made template. I'm gonna delete, for example, this item and add a piece of dynamic text here, dynamic product list here. And I'm gonna customize it based on cross-selling related to last order. So, and I'm gonna add some spacer here and customize the appearance a bit. So I'm going to save this email, and as you can see, I can also change the scheduling for email. I can say immediately after they place an order, they should receive this, or I can specify a date and time and more items. We create custom segments. Like I said, there's 100 different filters covering personal, insight, shopping, and email activity. And I'm gonna, in this example, for example, choose the visit date. For example, all the people whose first visit date is exactly on, let's say, 1st of April. And I'm gonna add one more filter to it related to, let's say, the sign up date. And I want them to have an exact sign up date of, let's say, 4th of April. And I also want to add one more filter related to the shopping behavior. Let's say they have a they have had an abandoned cart. So, and I want the duration of the abandoned cart to be, for example, 20 or 10 hours. And that's it. I save this segment. I'm gonna say recent abandoners. So I just created this custom segment. Additionally, I can use ready-made segments. As you can see, there are many different ready-made segments that help us, Growmatik does, in order to save a lot of time for you. You see active customers, at-risk customers, you see all of these different groups of people who are showing a specific behavior can be immediately chosen from here. For example, I'm gonna choose potential customers. Growmatik populates different filters, as you can see, but we can choose them however we want. So your automation starts operating. You can see the analytics and performance of automation based on the type of action it has, the engagement and conversion metrics, number of signups, the revenue generated, and everything. You can see the general performance reports in the reports page covering the site engagement, the sales, and the statistics about customers. All these metrics, as you can see here, and also the statistics about email engagement.